What if I told you something this small, a hearing aid, could fight dementia? Would you get your butt to the audiologist and get your hearing tested? I want you to imagine for a minute that your brain is a gas tank, that it contains only a finite amount of fuel. As we get older and our hearing gets worse, our brain burns more fuel to listen, more fuel to comprehend. But the more fuel, the more cognitive resources devoted just to listening, the less fuel there is for other tasks, like memory. Now, I want you to imagine running like this, empty gas tank scenario, for 10 years. This is the average amount of time an adult with hearing loss waits before seeking treatment. Hearing loss is much more common than you might think. About half of us in this room will start to show signs of hearing loss in our 50s. 80% of us by the time we reach our 80s. Despite this statistic, only about 30% of us have ever gotten a hearing test. But what if I told you hearing loss was linked to lasting consequences? First, hearing loss is linked to cognitive decline. Risk of dementia increases 2- to 5-fold when hearing loss is present. Second, hearing loss is linked to structural and functional changes in the brain. Hearing centers of the brain literally atrophy or may be repurposed by other senses like vision and touch. And third, hearing loss takes an emotional toll. People with hearing loss are 2 times more likely to be depressed. So what do we do about it? That's where my research comes in. I'm an audiologist and a neuroscientist, and for my dissertation study, I took a group of adults with normal hearing and a group of adults with early stage mild hearing loss. Some of them didn't even know that they had a hearing loss when they came into the study. I looked at differences in baseline brain function, cognitive function, and social emotional status between the two groups. I then fit the adults with hearing loss with a pair of state-of-the-art hearing aids. Guess what I found? Within 6 months of hearing aid use, the adults with hearing loss are already showing signs of more typical brain function. Specific aspects like working memory and executive function have improved. And this is mild hearing loss. I leave you with this thought. Routine screens like mammograms are standard of care when we reach our 50s. Why not hearing screenings? What if one small change, getting to the audiologist, taking that hearing test, trying a pair of hearing aids, might have a bigger, more long-lasting impact than you think? Thank you.